स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट एल्गोरिथम्स एंड असिम्प्टोटिक एफिशिएंसी ऑफ एल्गोरिथम. नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट टाइप्स ऑफ असिम्प्टोटिक नोटेशन. वी नो दैट व्हाई वी यूज असिम्प्टोटिक नोटेशन. दे आर मैथमेटिकल वे ऑफ रिप्रेजेंटिंग द टाइम कम्प्लेक्सिटी एंड दे आर यूज इन प्रायर एनालिसिस. प्रायर एनालिसिस मीन दैट वी डोंट एग्जीक्यूट द एल्गोरिथम. So there are three types of asymptotic notation. First is Big O notation. When we use Big O notation, when we have only an asymptotically upper bound of the algorithm, then we use the Big O notation. When we say that our function fn is Big O of gn, when we have the condition that fn is greater than equal to 0 and less than equals to c times gn for all n greater than equals to n naught, where c and n naught are positive constants, then we say that our function fn is Big O of gn. This figure shows that our function fn is Big O of gn. We can see from this figure that for all n greater than equal to n naught, our function fn is less than equals to c times g. Suppose our function fn is 3n plus 2. Is this function Big O of n? We have to check. It will be Big O of n when 3n plus 2 is less than equals to c times n. For all n greater than equals to n naught. For n naught equals to 1 and for c equals to 4, we will check 3 into 1 plus 2 less than equals to 4 into 1, which is not true. So for c equals to 4 and now n naught equal to 2. 3 into 2 plus 2 less than equals to 4 into 2, which is true. If n naught equals to 3, then again this condition will be true. So we can say that for c equals to 4 and for all n greater than equal to n naught, where n naught is equal to 2, our function fn, that is 3n plus 2, is Big O of n. Another example, function fn is equal to n cube plus n plus 5 is Big O of n cube. So we have to check n cube plus n plus 5 is less than equals to c times n cube. So if we take c equals to 7 and n naught equal to 1, we will check 1 plus 1 plus 5 less than equals to 7 into 1, which is true. So if we increase the value of n naught, this condition will always be true. So we can say that for c equals to 7 and for all n greater than equal to 1, our condition is true. So we can say that function fn, that is n cube plus n plus 5, is Big O of n cube. One point is that Big O notation is used to capture all upper bound, but we prefer the least upper bound. Least upper bound means, suppose our function is any function fn is Big O of n cube, then it will be Big O of n raised to power 4 also. It will be Big O of n raised to power 5 also, and so on. But we take the least upper bound, that is Big O of n cube. Another example, we have to prove that function 3 raised to power n is not Big O of 2 raised to power n. So we can prove it by contradiction. Let us suppose that our function 3 raised to power n is Big O of 2 raised to power n. So 3 raised to power n should be less than equals to c times 2 raised to power n. Dividing both sides by 2 raised to power n, we will get 1.5 raised to power n should be less than equals to c, which is a contradiction, because we have already told that c is a constant. So it cannot depend on the value of n. So our supposition is wrong. And we can say that 3 raised to power n is not Big O of 2 raised to power n. सेकेंड नोटेशन इज बिग ओमेगा नोटेशन. जस्ट एज बिग ओ नोटेशन प्रोवाइड्स असिम्प्टोटिकली अपर बाउंड ऑन द फंक्शन, बिग ओमेगा नोटेशन प्रोवाइड्स असिम्प्टोटिकली लोअर बाउंड ऑन द फंक्शन. सो फॉर अ गिवन फंक्शन जी एन, वेन वी विल से दैट अवर फंक्शन एफ एन इज बिग ओमेगा ऑफ जी एन, वेन अवर फंक्शन एफ एन इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू सी टाइम्स जी एन विच इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू जीरो. अगेन फॉर ऑल एन ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू एन नॉट, वेयर सी एंड एन नॉट आर द पॉजिटिव कॉन्स्टेंट्स. दिस फिगर शोज दैट अवर फंक्शन एफ एन इज बिग ओमेगा ऑफ जी एन, बिकॉज फॉर ऑल एन ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू एन नॉट अवर फंक्शन एफ एन इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू सी टाइम्स जी एन. सो वी कैन से दैट फंक्शन एफ एन इज बिग ओमेगा ऑफ जी एन. अगेन बिग ओमेगा कैन बी यूज टू डिनोट ऑल लोअर बाउंड्स ऑफ द एल्गोरिदम, बट वी प्रेफर द ग्रेटेस्ट लोअर बाउंड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ अवर फंक्शन एफ एन इज बिग ओमेगा ऑफ एन रेज टू पावर फोर, देन इट विल बी बिग ओमेगा ऑफ एन रेज टू पावर क्यू एंड बिग ओमेगा ऑफ एन रेज टू पावर टू, बट वी विल टेक द ग्रेटेस्ट लोअर बाउंड. इट इज यूज इन द बेस्ट केस एनालिसिस ऑफ द एल्गोरिथम, एज बिग ओ इज यूज इन द वर्स्ट केस एनालिसिस ऑफ द एल्गोरिथम. सिमिलरली बिग ओमेगा नोटेशन इज यूज इन द बेस्ट केस एनालिसिस ऑफ द एल्गोरिथम. Let us take one example. Suppose function fn is 3n plus 2. Is this big omega of n? We have already proved that this is big O of n. We have to prove that this is big omega of n. Now we will check. It will be big omega of n if 3n plus 2 is greater than equals to c times n. For c is equal to constant. Let us take c equals to 1 and n not equals to 1. So 3 plus 2, 5 is greater than equals to 1. True. If we take n not equal to 2, 3 into 2, 6 plus 2, 8 greater than equals to 2. So this is true. So we can say that for c equal to 1 and n greater than equals to 1, our function fn is big omega of n. Another example. Prove that function fn n cube plus n plus 5 is big omega of n cube. When this will be true, if n cube plus n plus 5 is greater than equals to c times n cube. If we take c equal to 1 and n not equal to 1, then this condition is true. Because 1 plus 1 plus 5, 7 is greater than equals to 1. If we take n equal to n naught equal to 2, 2 into 2 raised to power 3, 8 plus 2, 10 plus 5, 15 greater than equal to 8. So as we will increase the value of n, this condition is true. So we can say that for c equals to 1 and for all n greater than equals to 1, our condition is true. And our function fn, that is n cube plus n plus 5, is big omega of n cube. Another example, prove that 3n square plus 2 is not big omega of n cube. So we have to check it. If it is big omega of n cube, then 3n square plus 2 is greater than equals to c times n cube. Dividing both sides by n cube, we will get 3n square plus 2 by n cube should be greater than equals to c. That is, value of c is depending upon n. So this is contradiction because c is any positive constant. So we can say that our supposition is wrong. So our function fn is not big omega of n cube. Third notation is theta notation. When our function fn is theta of another function gn, if fn is greater than equals to c1 times gn and less than equals to c2 times gn, where c1 times gn is also greater than equals to 0. For all n greater than equals to n0 and n0 and c are positive constant, then we can say that our function fn is theta of gn. This is the graph for fn is equal to theta of gn. Our function fn is greater than equals to some positive constant times gn and less than equals to another positive constant times gn for all n greater than equals to n0. We can say that our function fn is theta of gn. Theta notation can be used to denote tight bounds of the algorithm. So when we say that function fn is theta of gn, it means our function fn is big omega of gn and function fn is also big O of gn. Then we can say that our function fn is theta of gn. For example, we have to prove that function fn 10n square plus 4n plus 2 is equal to theta of n square. So first we will prove that it is big O of n square. For proving that big O of n square, our function fn, that is 10n square plus 4n plus 2, should be less than equals to c1 times n square for all n greater than equals to n0. Let us take n0 equal to 1. So 10 plus 4 plus 2, 16, and c1 equals to 20. So 10 plus 4 plus 2, 16, less than equals to 20 into 1, which is 2. If we increase the value of n to 2, 2 raised to power 2, 4, 40 plus 8, 48 plus 2, 50, less than equals to 20 into 4, 80, which is 2, and so on. Increasing the value of n naught will not affect this equation. So this equation is true for c1 is equal to 20 and n0 is equal to 1. So we can say that this function is big O of n square. Now we have to prove that this is also big omega of n square. When it will be big omega of n square? If 10n square plus 4n plus 2 is greater than equals to c2 times n square. Let us take c2 is equal to 10 and n0 is equal to 1. We check 10 plus 4, 14 plus 2, 16, greater than equal to 10 into 1, that is true. If we take value of n is equal to 2, then also this condition will be true. So we can say that for c1 equals to 20 and c2 equals to 10 and n0 equal to 1, our function is both big of n square as well as big omega of n square. Hence we can say that our function is theta of n square. So this concludes the topic types of asymptotic notation. Hope these concepts are clear to you. In the next video we will discuss some examples for calculating the complexity of the algorithms. Thank you.